start. 3, 2, 1. Boosters in ignition. And liftoff of Artemis 1. We rise together back to the moon and beyond.
The world watched in wonder as NASA's new SLS rocket blasted off from Cape Canaveral last month, step one in a triumphant return of mankind to the moon.
NASA's new Artemis mission aims to put the first woman and first person of color onto the lunar surface in just a few years. But step one, making sure all the new equipment works.
Yeah, and that's what we've been seeing going on now. And joining us to talk about it live via Zoom from Cape Canaveral, Florida, is NASA's Orion Deputy Program Manager, Debbie Korth. Debbie, thank you so much for being here. Welcome.
Yeah, well, thank you for having me. I'm glad to be here.
So just big picture, just what is the overall major goal of Artemis?
Goal of Artemis is return humanity to the moon as a whole program and have a sustained presence there. So this won't be just visits to the moon. This will be a sustained presence both on the surface and around the moon. Main goal of Artemis 1 that we just launched, that spectacular launch you saw, it was a spectacular 8 minutes, and now we're 18 days into our 26-day mission of the Orion spacecraft. And we couldn't be more pleased about how the spacecraft is operating and performing well beyond our expectations.
You talk about that Artemis 1 launch. When you witnessed that last November from Cape Canaveral, what was it like? What was your reaction watching that biggest rocket ever being built and blast off?
Yeah, it was spectacular. There was so much anticipation. I mean, as you know, we had a couple of scrub attempts, and so when we actually got to the day where it was going to go, just the anticipation in the room and the excitement, you know, knowing we're sending a spacecraft further than any human rated spacecraft's ever gone before, you know, opening up the lunar vicinity to a larger set of crews in the future. And so you could just feel the excitement and the anticipation of what's coming next.
And the images are just incredible. It's awesome to hear your excitement too. And so far it has been a series of successes. The SLS rocket worked. Orion made it to the moon, achieved orbit, and then the Orion capsule just left the moon's orbit on Thursday. It's on its way back to Earth. So what are you watching for now?
Mostly we're watching for the remaining test objectives. So when we sent the spacecraft up, we had 160 test objectives. We're about halfway through, a little more than halfway through. So we have a lot of test objectives to get through as a part of the reentry and landing phase. So we'll be watching the burns on our way back. We've added some detailed test objectives that are looking at propulsion performance, thermal performance, our attitude control. And all these are designed to help open up the operational envelope of Orion. So, you know, if we consume less prop, like right now we're seeing we're consuming a whole lot less propellant than we thought. We're producing more power than we thought. Our heaters aren't having to operate as much as we had originally anticipated. So all those things feed forward into the next missions where we actually can do more activities because we'll have more capability that we aren't using on the spacecraft. So coming home, the biggest objective we'll be looking at coming home is the reentry phase and the performance of our heat shield, which protects the crew module occupants from the extreme heats. It's about 5,000 degrees that the spacecraft gets to when it reenters.
And some incredible images have been coming back to us. What's your reaction when you see these images?
Yeah, they're fantastic. You know, it's hard for us to pay attention sometimes to the data coming down because we're too busy watching the imagery. Great views of the Earth and the moon and the spacecraft. You know, we put these cameras out on the ends of the solar arrays, and so getting great selfies of the spacecraft throughout the whole mission. So just phenomenal. And we'll be getting more as part of the lunar flyby, a return-powered flyby that'll be coming up on Monday.
Okay, tell us a little bit about that, because Orion is set to land back on Earth December 11th. So what will we see over the next week?
So coming up on Monday will be another lunar powered flyby. So we'll be getting within about 79 miles of the surface of the moon at its closest point. Again, that'll be on the backside. So we'll be in darkness and we'll actually lose comm with the vehicle again for about 40 minutes. We'll also get some images of the Apollo landing sites. We'll be a little further away, about 6,000 miles above the lunar surface when we see those. So lots of great more lunar imagery to come. And then, like I said, coming home, we'll be testing different attitude maneuvers, looking at how we limit our propellant usage. And then finally, the reentry phase, where we have a series of 11 parachutes that deploy in sequence to kind of slow the vehicle down from its reentry speed of 25,000 miles per hour down to 20 miles per hour when it hits the water there off the coast of San Diego.
All right. So next mission, Artemis 2, will send astronauts around the moon. Then Artemis 3 will put humans back on the moon. How exactly when would we know that we are ready for that step?
So coming back from Artemis 1, we have a lot of data to pour over. We also have some equipment that's coming off of that vehicle that we're reusing on Artemis 2. The Artemis 2 vehicle is already well on its way of being built. It's down at our factory at the Kennedy Space Center. We are finished up the initial power on tests of that vehicle. So, you know, we'll be testing out those avionics coming back, putting those in the vehicle and sending it on its way through the rest of its program. And Artemis 3 is also well on its way to being built. The actual crew cabin, the pressure vessel for Artemis 3, is also being outfitted now with all of its power and environmental control equipment.
Debbie, I'm curious, you know, why do you think we stopped going to the moon after the Apollo missions? And what has really been the catalyst of trying to get humans back onto the moon?
Yeah, you know, I think there was a big focus on the space shuttle and the International Space Station program. So, you know, kind of went away from the moon and went more towards low Earth orbit, where we can do a lot of science, a lot of transportation of crew members. You know, that's now opened up a commercial crew industry and capability that's kind of going to be more prominent in low Earth orbit. And I think that enabled us to now look ahead for more exploration, which takes you to the moon and ultimately to Mars.
Debbie, we thank you so much for your time.
Don't forget. So incredible.
Yeah, really.
So great to hear about.
Artemis 1's Orion capsule is set to splash back down to Earth on December 11th, and you can stay up to date at nasa.com/trackArtemis, or you can follow on the social media channels.
Don't go away. We'll be right back.